They're here in a big way in a lot of places. Some places you just see a handful or a couple here and there. Talking about the cicadas, of course, we are pleased to be joined by the bug guy, Dr. Yes. Michael Raupp, Professor Emeritus at the University of Maryland. Great to have
Good
you
morning.
On, as always. It's a pleasure. Just give us an update now of where exactly we are in the timeline of these cicadas here in Maryland.
Hey, good morning, C4 and Bryan. We're right where at go time in the timeline, gentlemen. The cicadas are up and out of the ground. The big boy band is rocking it in the treetop here in Columbia, Maryland, and several other places around the area. And I guarantee you, with temperatures today, tomorrow, through the weekend, in the 80s and 90s, these guys are going to be up and out in force. So We're kind of peaking. We're hitting the big stride of the Cicadapalooza. It's going to be pretty darn spectacular for the next 2 or 3 weeks here, gang.
The bug guy is on board with us, everyone. Entomologist renowned Dr. Michael Raupp on board, extension specialist at University of Maryland. Look, Dr. Raupp, when it comes to this, I want to get right to it because Bryan has been teasing this all morning, the zombie effect that's hitting the cicadas. You know, what exactly is this? And I've looked a little bit into this, Dr. Raupp. They're connected to psychedelic mushrooms, whatever this thing is.
Whoa.
Well, the mushrooms aren't exactly psychedelic. This is one of the craziest stories I've ever heard in my entire life. I'm going to give a shout out to my buddies, Matt Casson and Brian Lovett over at University of West Virginia, who are pioneering this research. So it's not mine, but it's theirs. This is a great story. Here's how it goes. There's a fungus called Massospora cicadini. It lays in wait for 17 years in the soil, waiting for periodical cicadas to emerge. Once the cicadas emerge, the spores will land on their skin. They're going to germinate. They're going to invade the body of the cicada like an army. Once they're inside, they're going to multiply. Once they multiply, then a couple of really weird things are going to happen. Number one, the male cicada will now be infected. He will go off and he will still attempt to mate with females, thereby spreading the Massospora to the females. Now this Massospora becomes an STD in the cicada population. Hold it, guys. Hold it. Don't laugh yet. Hold it. Don't peek here on me, because the best is yet to come. Now, the other cool thing that Massospora does, now, up in the treetops, I got to backstep here a minute. Basically, what's going on right now, the guys and the gals are getting eyeball to eyeball in the treetops. The male has to use his very best performance. Guys, we know about performance and performance anxiety, but cicadas have it too.
Hey, you're getting personal, doctor. Go ahead, please.
Well, I'm not talking about myself here, gentlemen. But anyway, the cicadas, the male cicada basically has to use his best call, his best song to woo his mate. If he is successful, if she digs this guy, she's going to flick her wings and make a little clicking noise like this. They're going to hook up and mate, right? Mm-hmm. What Massospora does is it takes mind control over the male cicada when he's infected. It's going to zombieize him.
Oh my God.
So the male cicada now mimics the wing flick of a female. That attracts other males that attempt to mate with him.
Whoa.
Further disperses Massospora through the populations of cicada. Boom. Now, is that crazy or what?
This is ghoulish.
It sounds like a Game of Thrones episode.
It is.
I mean, it's
medieval. This is medieval.
Guys, this whole thing is better than the Game of Thrones. Come on, go out in your backyard, watch nature. It's going to be crazy. Now, you'll actually see cicadas. Their entire abdomen has been turned into a fungus garden. That's where the flying salt shakers of death comes in as they move about. They're basically spreading these fungal spores all over the environment. Those spores are going to go to the ground, and they're going to wait another 13 or 17 years for cicadas to appear.
That is
crazy.
Amazing.
You can't make this stuff up, guys.
I got to ask a quick question, Bryan, real quick, and that is, is any of this, because people want to know, if it hits you or touches you, it's not, like, contagious or anything. They won't do anything to you, will it? these spores.
Oh, yeah, it's gonna zombieize you guys. Don't touch those. Are you kidding me? Don't do that. You know, you're gonna be acting crazy if you do this. Absolutely.
I'm sorry.
No.
Sorry, bro.
Run. No, absolutely not. This is, okay. I'm teasing you guys, of course. This is a specialist on periodical cicadas. So, yeah, don't worry about it. You're going to be okay.
Okay.
Even if you eat them, right? Because
Bryan,
that's the thing.
No, guys, listen. Bryan, you don't eat things with fungus on them.
No.
You know,
okay.
I've been snacking on several cicadas lately, but I avoid the ones with the fungus. Don't go there.
All right.
Don't
Very
go
good.
There.
Yeah. That is one of the most fascinating studies that I've ever heard. It is strange but cool at the same time.
It's disgusting.
Is it just real quickly? Is it worse this year than it has been in the previous years, or do we not know at this point?
No, really, this is something we see every brood of cicadas. Yeah. We're going to see it. It will, of course, vary with conditions of humidity, density. Timing of the population. So we usually begin to see this a little bit later in the populations. The cicadas right now, and eventually it'll blow out their abdomen. So it's crazy. You're going to see cicadas flying around. You're going to see cicadas flying around, and they've got no rear end, but they're still flying around through the sky, walking up trees. It's crazy.
God bless you, Dr. Raupp. Yeah. Man, I'm done.
That is neat stuff.
Okay.
Great to have you on, Doc. We appreciate it.
Enjoy some cicadas. Yeah, enjoy some cicadas. Snack on some if you'd like. Don't let your ovary eat too many. But avoid the ones with the fuzzy abdomen, guys.
Trust me, I will.
Is there a bag for this flight? Oh, my goodness.
Dr. Michael Raupp, bug guy, University of Maryland, with the latest on the cicadas and the zombie cicadas and the sex-crazed zombie
STDs.
Cicadas. STDs. gay cicadas, apparently. I don't know. Whatever you want to call it. It's crazy.